Today's video, I'm going to teach you how to install Google Analytics to your WordPress site. And I'm going to teach you how to install it without the need of installing any additional plugins. Because we both know that the more plugins we have, the slower our site will become. And we don't need that. So follow along, because this is how you do it. So for this tutorial, I will be using this page as my reference page while I walk you through the tutorial. As you can see, here's my page, and here is the account that is for the same page. You can see right now we have zero traffic. That's because there is no script on the site because I just removed it. So to add your Google Analytics script, you first need to have the script. So you go to your account for the page that you want, then you go to admin, and from admin you go to property, then you click tracking info, and then tracking code. And you scroll down, and here you can see your tracking code. So what you do, you copy it, copy code, and then you go to appearance, and then you go to your theme editor. So appearance, theme editor. Okay, so now you're in here. Then on your right side, you will find all the files. So on the top right, you can see, this is my theme. If I click here, you can see the 2019 and so on. But this is the theme that I'll be using. So that should be checked. Then just scroll down and you look for the header. Where is the header file? Header.php. There it is. You click it. Now when you're in the file, you need to find the clothing tag for the head tag. So you can scroll down here, or you just press Control F and you type it, the clothing tag for the head, and you press Enter. And as you see on my page, it shows it. So what you need to do now, you need to put the tracking code that we just copied from Google Analytics. It should be above your closing head tag. So it will be here. You can just make some tabs so it doesn't connect with the others, like that. Then you just do Control V, as in paste, and there's the code. So now when the code is in place, you scroll down and you click Update. Go to Real Time Overview. So we still have zero traffic. It's because we haven't refreshed this page. So let's try to refresh it. Refreshed, we go back to Analytics. And there is one visitor, that's me. That's it. Just one more thing. Make sure that you have a child theme installed as well, of your theme. And that you put the code in the child theme's header and not in the main theme's header. What will happen if you have it in the main theme's header, and each time you update the theme, that header file will be overwritten and you will lose your tracking. So make sure that you always have a child theme and that you have that code placed in the child theme's header. If you did find this tutorial helpful and you want to learn more about WooCommerce and WordPress, make sure you hit the subscribe button, turn on the notifications, and stay safe.